Good morning, student. Today I will explain about electrovalent bond. Electrovalent bond is formed by complete transfer of electron from one atom to another. We'll take example of sodium chloride. Sodium electronic configuration is 2, 8, 1. In order to obtain a stable electronic configuration of nearest noble gas, it has to lose one electron. Whereas chlorine electronic configuration is 2, 8, 7. So in order to obtain a stable electronic configuration, it has to gain one electron. Therefore, sodium will donate one electron and chlorine will gain one electron to obtain stable electronic configuration, resulting in the formation of cation and anion. The cation and anions, being oppositively charged, attract each other very strongly with the help of electrostatic forces. So that is why this type of bond form is called electrovalent bond. Is it clear? How electrovalent bond is formed? This bond is formed by the complete transfer of electron from one atom to another, normally from metal to non-metal. Now we will discuss conditions which are needed for the formation of electrovalent bond. First condition, atom should have low ionization potential. Metals have low ionization potential, hence they can easily lose electron to form cation. What is the second condition? Second condition, high electron affinity. Non-metals have high electron affinity, so easily they can gain electron to form anion. These are the two conditions. One condition, atom should have low ionization potential, metal should have low ionization potential, and second one is high electron affinity. So you already know that non-metals are having high electron affinity. What is the third condition? There should be large difference in the electronegativity. It means one should be electropositive, highly electropositive, whereas other should be highly electronegative. Then only electrovalent bond will be formed. If there is very less difference in their electronegativity or no difference, then it will result in the formation of covalent bond. So this is the third condition. Okay, so what are the three conditions which are needed for the formation of electrovalent bond? Number one, low ionization potential. Number two, high electron affinity. And third one is large difference in electronegativity. Why? One by one again. Why low ionization potential? So that atom can easily lose electron to form cation. Why second? High electron affinity. So that non-metal can easily gain electron to form anion. Okay, so we will discuss now example in detail how calcium oxide is formed. Okay, formation of calcium oxide. Now see the electronic configuration of calcium. Electronic configuration of calcium is 2, 8, 8, 2. In order to obtain a stable electronic configuration of nearest noble gas, that is argon, it has to lose 2 electrons. So due to low ionization potential, it can easily lose 2 electrons to form cation, calcium 2+. Whereas electronic configuration of oxygen is 2, 6. So in order to obtain a stable electronic configuration of nearest noble gas, that is neon, it has to gain 2 electrons. Oxygen has very high electron affinity, so it will quickly gain two electron lost by calcium to form oxide ion, resulting in the formation of calcium cation and oxide anion. Both are being oppositively charged, attract each other with a very strong force that is known as electrostatic force, and this type of bond will be known as ionic bond. So one more example is there, that is magnesium chloride. Formation of magnesium chloride, three figures you should practice. Try to draw electron dot figure of sodium chloride, calcium oxide and magnesium chloride. Okay, so magnesium chloride mein electronic configuration of magnesium is what? 2A2. It can easily lose two electron. But chlorine electronic configuration is 2-8-7. It means one chlorine atom can gain only one electron. So magnesium combined with two chlorine atom. Is it clear? Because magnesium, in order to obtain a stable electronic configuration, it has to lose two electron. But one atom of chlorine can gain only one electron. Therefore, two chlorine atoms are required to combine with magnesium. Okay, so magnesium will lose two electron to form cation, whereas two chlorine atom will gain one electron to form anions. So what will be the formula of magnesium chloride? MgCl2. Is it clear? Then what are the characteristics of electrovalent bond? All electrovalent compounds are crystalline solid. Why they are crystalline solid? Due to presence of very strong force of attraction, that is electrostatic force. This is the first characteristic. And they are water soluble. Okay, mostly they are water soluble. Due to polar nature of water, that I will discuss in second video under heading of covalent compound. So here just you should know certain characteristic. First one, ki all electrovalent compounds are crystalline solid. Second one, they are water soluble and they are good conductor of electricity in which state? Not in solid state. A solid state mein ions are not free. They are held together by very strong electrostatic forces. So they conduct electricity either in aqueous state or in molten state. Because in aqueous and molten state only ions will be free. Okay, so this point you have to remember, ki electrovalent compound will conduct electricity only in aqueous or molten state. Okay.